always tell people I had three dreams. One was to get a full scholarship to college. Second one was to make an Olympic team and then play professionally. But going into my senior year in high school, I was only 5'3", weighed 130 pounds. So before I went to BU, I went to Massasoit Community College. And that's because being one of eight, that's the only one we could afford. They say goaltending is just stop the puck and leave the goalie alone, and they're all different, right? Everybody always says that. But what I learned is, in order to do my job really well, I had to learn all the skills and weaknesses of all the players in front of me so that I could utilize their strengths and their weaknesses at times where it would make myself better. So I think that's really important. So in order to do something really great, you need your teammates, and you need to be able to count on them and trust them. You know, when I made the Olympic team, it was a really exciting moment for me because a lot of other people other than myself made a lot of personal sacrifices, and I made the most of that opportunity. That's sort of like people joining Foley's firm. That's the first step. The second thing I had was when I was able to walk into the Olympic ceremonies with the greatest athletes in the world. Now, you can be comfortable that you're in this firm, or you can say, now I get a chance to see what the best of the best do and how and what I need to do to get better. Individually, we had all been successful, and that was not going to take us to the level we needed to get to.
Rob McClanahan, St. Paul, Minnesota.
Who do you play for?
For you, here at the U.
Jack?
Jack O'Callaghan, Charlestown, Mass. Boston University.
When you pull on that jersey, you represent yourself and your teammates. And a name on the front is a hell of a lot more important than the one on the back. Get that through your head. Again.
That scene was indicative of Herb explaining to us that we can't win, we can't do what we need to do individually. We're not from separate teams, we're all on the same team. And then he did so many other things, as you know, he made himself the common enemy because he had a short period of time to do something. He put us in that winning underdog role. And so very symbolic there, because at the time, and there was a couple times in the movie Miracle where the audience gets to see that, is after the game in Norway when he skates us.
You guys don't want to work during the game? No problem, we'll work now. Goal line.
We didn't prepare, and so what happened is, he held us accountable. And then when we looked at ourselves and really went deep inside, we found out we were three separate teams on the same team. Guys who knew they were going to make it, guys who thought they were going to make it, and guys who hoped they were going to make it. And you can't win something epic by not everybody doing their job. So as simple as it sounds, you have to know your job, and you have to do your job.
You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable.
The game ends, and you know, I had lost my mother to cancer earlier, and my father, I thought I would such an important victory. See, people think personal sacrifice is something that they do individually, and personal sacrifice is when somebody else, and in this case, my mother and my father, gave me so many opportunities, and all they wanted me to do is make the most of them. And so when the game ended, I was looking for my father to show appreciation of how much I respected what my mother had done for me as well as him. And as I was doing that, some fan put this flag on my shoulder, and it kind of fell. And so I made sure, you know, you respect the American flag, you kind of hold it. And that's the story. The best thing about my father was that he never drove the passion out of me. I think there's a lot of times that you don't even know what passion is, and people try to put you in a situation. You know, parents have a business plan for the kid, that you're gonna do this, you're gonna do this, you're gonna do this. And sometimes you just have to explore and be passionate about it and chase your dream. And I tell people, if you don't have a dream, how can you make it come true? And my father was supportive of my dreams to the point where he's the best man at my wedding. The accountability part is when people understand that they're part of something bigger than themselves, that the brand and what they're doing and how they do it is going to affect everybody within the firm. And they're either going to make your job easier or you're going to make your job more difficult. And that's why I always tell people that the 500 partners that you have, the 1,000 lawyers that you have, that's your locker room. And you have to hold them accountable inside that locker room. And once you do that, it's hard to get people, and you become the best recruiters for people who you let become a partner. And I think that's important. And, you know, I tell people there's three things that's really important to me: family first, doing the right thing, and then winning with integrity. And that's what all great companies that are successful really do. That isn't just, oh, I'm a partner and, you know, I have a great life. It's not about I have a great wine selection or I got out in my boat this weekend. It's really about you're helping people and their legacies. And are you any good at it? What are your weaknesses? You know, what can you add to this firm that make people want you to be a partner? You want to talk about a team that couldn't manage through ego and conflict. It was the Russians. And when the game got late, they always won. They didn't panic. You know, they were the greatest. Everybody was afraid of them. So they had an aura about them. But Herb had every one of us just do our job. And if you watch the movie, he said, play your game. Play your game. Well, what the Russians did is they kept their best six players out. So they went from a bench of 20 players to basically a bench of six where you had the rest of the players become passengers waiting for them to happen. And if you want to stay young, you can't let that happen. So Foley can't let that happen. They've always got to have people play their game and be collectively better, not individually good. So for everybody who is an individual success within Foley, that's not as good as everybody being collectively successful. And the Russians lost, and we won that game because everybody did their job.